I just want to say how much I want to be with my family right now. This is really difficult. Not being with everyone physically, but I'm so glad that we have this opportunity to be with each other this way.
Alejandro Aguilan Camacho, fondly known as Alex Camacho, an officer and a gentleman. My darling father, my ever-loving Papa. Papa was born on the 3rd of October, 1927, in the Philippine province of Pangasinan. He went to primary school up to high school in the city of San Carlos, which was not far from where he was born. He moved to Manila and joined the army after high school and rose from the ranks, joining the armed forces of the Philippines, based in Camp Aguinaldo in Quezon City. It was during his time that he met Mama, Clarita Camacho, whom he married and eventually had five children with. It was also in this season of his life that he got his Bachelor of Arts degree, major in political science at the University of Manila. After which, he was commissioned as a military officer with the rank of second lieutenant. He then got called to active duty with the Philippine Army and worked at the intelligence services of the armed forces of the Philippines. Later, he was assigned to work as a military attaché at the Philippine Embassy in Washington, D.C., in the United States of America. When he got back to the Philippines after that four-year tour of duty, he worked for the Office of the Executive Secretary of the Philippines, the Honorable Secretary Alejandro Melchor, nicknamed as the Little President during that time. He then took an optional retirement from the military and was offered a job to manage a large catering company named Galaxy Catering International. He was a personal manager for this company, looking after thousands of contract workers who were sent to the Middle East in Saudi Arabia to help build their growing infrastructure. Years later, he retired and went back to the Philippines for good. Being the way he is, Papa could not stop and retire, so became actively involved with church, being one of the founding elders of Green Hills Christian Fellowship. He became the first building administrator, drafted by the founding pastor, Reverend David Yont. He joined the charter members of GCF and was a teacher of a growth group called Horizon. He was also a mentor and had discipled many of the church leaders and has always been a prayer warrior for many church members, but most especially the Board of Elders. He moved to New Zealand in the year 2010 to take up residency with Mama and my sister Lynn. He became a member and a strong prayer warrior of Cornerstone Christian Church and was a wonderful and kind participant of the community of Wayuku. He lived a full life with five children, 13 grandchildren, and four great-grandchildren. This year would have marked his 65th wedding anniversary with Mama, the one true love of his life. He left an amazing legacy of love, loyalty, kindness, and generosity. But above all, what truly spoke volumes was his love for God and an attitude of gratitude for life's many blessings. This awesome legacy of Papa will continue in his family throughout this generation and for the many generations to come. We thank God for Papa's wonderful life that has been well and fully lived, and now even more so with full and radiant joy in his new heavenly home with his Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
cloud so funny sways. Gone are the days when he would take me on his knee, and with a smile he chased my tears to laughter. Oh, my papa, me was so wonderful. Deep in my heart, I miss him so today.
From my experience, so abundant and generous with his love, and a grand example of a gentleman. So, how big a heart to hold all the love that Lolo and Lola have grown, I am inspired to know. But I do know this, the ache in our heart is holy because it's a fraction of the love that Lolo had for each of us. And this space that we hold together is sacred and it's healing. And Lolo would have loved to be here with us right now, and in many ways he is. So my tribute to Lolo is not a Bible verse or a song or a poem. Oh, but it is a poem, an excerpt of an E.E. Cummings poem, which goes like this. I carry your heart with me. I carry it in my heart. I am never without it. Anywhere I go, you go. Here's the deepest secret nobody knows. Here's the root of the root and the bud of the bud and the sky of a tree called life, which grows higher than the soul can hope or mind can hide. And this is the wonder that's keeping the stars apart. I carry your heart. I carry it in my heart. So may we carry this legacy of love with grace, reverence, and joy in each of our hearts. I will always, always, and forever be grateful for my Lolo and for such a beautiful family. I love each and every one of you, and I hope to squeeze you all soon.
Thank you, Lord, for my Papa, who mirrored and modeled your love to me. It was awe-inspiring and encouraging for me to understand why my Heavenly Father loved me so much because of my Papa's love. Yes, my loving Father's love of unselfish service and sacrifice by working abroad in both the United States of America and the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, so that his family would live a good and decent lifestyle, and to help me and my siblings complete our college education. I remember vividly what my loving Papa told of us, my siblings and I, that the best gift and inheritance he could give us is to complete our college degree, our college education. And God used our Papa to help us to be who we are, where we are, and what we have become today. Thank you, Lord, for my Papa's godly legacy. He loved Jesus as his Lord and personal Savior. He served God faithfully and selflessly. He was a servant leader. Whether he was performing the duty as officer of the Philippine Army a military attaché, like what my baby sister mentioned a while ago, a military attaché to the Philippine Embassy in Washington, D.C. He works as a branch manager of a catering company in Saudi Arabia. He was building administrator and chairman of the board of elders of one of the largest churches in Metro Manila, Green Hills Christian Fellowship, and many other positions. Personally, apart from God, my papa was the pillar of our clan. My papa was the one who made us appreciate and value good discipline. He was my mentor, and he was our mentor. My siblings and I can attest to that. He was our life coach and discipler. Papa lived a consistent life as a husband, as a father, as a grandfather, and a great grandfather, and as a friend, and even as an acquaintance to those whom he met in his life. Our friends and churchmates fondly and lovingly call him Papa Alex or Papa Camacho. His peers call him Kuya or Colonel out of their respect for my papa. By the grace and guidance of God that comforts me and my wife, in spite of not being able to travel to New Zealand to be with him during his last days because of this COVID-19 lockdown, I still thank the Lord for the daily video calls with my papa and family members in New Zealand. I thank God that I was able to tell him over and over again how much I love him and I appreciate everything that he has done for me and the rest of the family. I assured him that my siblings and I would take very good care of our beloved mom when Papa goes home to be with the Lord. I also told him, before he went home to be with the Lord, I told him not to wait for me anymore because the Lord Jesus Christ is already waiting for him. During his final days, I enjoyed reading to him his favorite Bible verses and singing his favorite hymns and other songs. And finally, by the grace of God, I was able to give him my pastoral prayer and benediction. My dearest Papa, your last night with us was a painful time of temporary separation, especially when I saw you breathe your last. But I am comforted and encouraged because of the blessed hope that one day I will see you again in the presence of our Heavenly Father. Papa, I love you very much. This is not goodbye, but good day, and see you in heaven.
Lola Alex, I don't really know where to start. All I know is that I miss you tremendously, and I wish I got to see you before you passed. I know I don't have a lot of time to say everything I want to say, so I'm going to get right to it. Lola Alex, you were my hero. I don't know if I've ever admitted this part out loud, but there was a point in time I felt like backing out of joining the military. I know a lot of people know that you're one of the biggest reasons I joined, but there was a point that I just wanted to not fulfill my commitment out of fear, out of anxiety. But you were the person that helped tip that balance, and you didn't really say anything. I was just reminded of your service, your leadership, and the respect that was shown to you. And I was inspired by you to fulfill my commitment and walk in your footsteps. I hope I made you proud. Thank you for being there for me. Thank you for being there for one of the most difficult times in my life when I was deployed to Iraq. But not just for that, but for being there and taking care of me for all of my life. You are still and always be and always will be. You are still and always will be a man whose example I will always want to follow. Your legacy has already impacted the generations that are here and the generations that are to come. Not very many people in life get to see their great-grandchildren, but you are definitely, but you definitely deserve to. I know that you met Laurel, but I wish you could have met, I mean, I know you met Adela, but I wish you could have met Laurel. But I promise you, I will tell her stories of you and your incredible life and legacy. As the eldest of my generation, I will do my utmost to lead and love like you did. A part of you will always live in all of us. I love you so very much, and I miss you. I'm glad I got to see you last October and say everything I wanted to say, and give you one last hug and see that last look on your face before I left, the look that you've always given me all my life, the look of love and pride for his grandson from as far back as I can remember.
My poem is called Home. Home. Is it a place? Is it a person? Is it a thing? Is it up to us to determine what home means? Some people know without a shadow of doubt that home to them is really their house. They spent time and hard labor of love to make it a safe place, a place to build memories, love more, laugh more, even make some mistakes. But to some, a house was never a home, but more the people that eventually come and go. Some stay a lifetime, some stay just for a season, but these people are their home, their safe places, and their reasons. For some of us, this has been a question we've wrestled with for most of our lives. Where is our home? Who is our home? Or am I really home this time? That's the end of my poem. Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also, and you know the way. And you know the way to where I am going. John 14:1-4. I thought home was the first house our family bought on the Big Island. I also thought it was someone I had recklessly given my heart to. I thought home was the moments that would turn into memories. I thought home was all of you. Looking back at Lolo's life has been the sweetest reminder of my purpose. Even after death, God has continued to use Lolo to teach me invaluable lessons. I can only imagine what Lolo thought of as he left his family to start his own with Lola. How he left the family he started to serve overseas for a time. How he left the Philippines to move to New Zealand. And how he left the earth to finally go home. I'm sure Lolo thought in those times of his life that he was leaving home, or going home, or coming home. However, I'm positive that at some point Lolo realized that that wasn't true, that those times in his life were all a part of the beautiful journey home that he's completed. How sweet to have a loving wife and solid partner, to father five amazing children, and to have seen all of his grandchildren, and to meet some of his great-grandchildren. What an amazing journey Lolo had. And what a testament of God's amazing grace and provision for Lolo's life. No matter where we think our home is, it is not here. It is not the house you live in. It is not the people around you. It is not the country you are proud of or not proud of at the moment. Because we are not where Lolo is, and Lolo went home. Thank you.
My tribute for Papa, like just a few photos, and because I'm going to get really emotional singing to him, I recorded the song. Just like Avenil said, the slideshow and my tribute is all about Papa being my hero.
My dearest Papa, Thank you for the laughter, for the good times that we've shared. Thank you for always listening, for trying to be fair. Thank you for your comfort when things are going bad. Thank you for your shoulder to cry on when I'm sad. This poem's a reminder that all my life through, I'll be thanking heaven for a father like you. Did you ever know that you're my hero? You're everything I would like to be. I can fly higher than an eagle, 'cause you are the wind beneath my appeared to go unnoticed, but I've got it all here in my heart. I want you to know, I know the truth, of course I know it. I would be nothing without you. Marching bands, no media hype, but through my eyes it's plain to see a hero God has sent to me. With gentle strength and quiet pride, all self-concern is set aside to reach out to people in need and be there with a helping hand. Heroes are very rare to find, a blessing to humanity. With all that you give and all that you do, Papa, my hero, has always been you.
Each morning, when we awake, we know that you are gone, and no one knows the heartache as we try to carry on. Our hearts still ache with sadness, and many tears still flow. What it meant to lose you, no one will ever know. Our thoughts are always with you, your place no one can fill. In life, we loved you dearly, in death, we love you still. There will always be a heartache, and often a silent tear, but always a precious memory of the days when you were here. If tears could make a staircase and heartaches make a lane, we'd walk the path to heaven and bring you back home again. We hold you close within our hearts and there you will remain, to walk with us throughout our lives until we meet again. And then this one is called I'm Free. I like to think this is kind of like from Lolo. So it says, don't grieve for me, for now I'm free. I'm following the path God has laid, you see. I took his hand when I heard his call. I turned my back and left it all. I could not stay another day to laugh, to love, to work, or play. Tasks left undone must stay that way. I found the peace at the close of day. If my parting has left a void, then fill it with remembered joys. A friendship shared, a laugh, a kiss. Yes, these things I too will miss. Be not burdened with times of sorrow. I wish you the sunshine of tomorrow. My life's been full, I savored much. Good friends, good times, a loved one's touch. Don't lengthen it now with undue grief. Lift up your hearts and peace to thee. God wanted me now, he set me free. I thought I'd keep it kind of short and simple. Not too many words like Lolo.
Thank you, Christy. Thank you, Munchkin. It's Noel. Adding Noel's turn.
Papa loves sports. You know, watching basketball games with Papa, boxing fights with Papa. He would walk to my house and we'd watch like until he falls asleep. But one of the most memorable games when I was young and I was playing, and two of the best players on the other side were my brothers. That was Kuya Abbott and Denden were on the other side. But it was memorable for me because Papa was on the sidelines watching us. I really don't know who won the game, but the highlight was Papa was watching.
We won the game. We won the game. Yeah. Our team won the game.
Fast forward, for some reason, Andy and June were playing a finals game and they were on the opposite sides. And Papa was there to watch them. And about 10 years ago here in New Zealand, when basketball was very, shall we say, you know, it was not very, very popular. I think Waiuku College was playing mata-mata. And, you know, I think they buried the other team by like 70, 80 points. And June and Andy were playing for Waiuku College. And the stands were empty, except for Papa. Sabi ni Papa, gumul! He was like really supporting. He was enjoying the game, even if he was just by himself on the stands. Talo na nga yung kalaban, inaasar pa niya. Gumol in his own way. He enjoyed sports. And I love to watch sports with Papa. I think lahat ng laban ni Pacquiao, Papa's watched it. And, you know, Craig would be with Papa. And, you know, he enjoyed sports. And Papa loves music. What I enjoy very much is Papa, when we sing hymns, the harmony would be there because Papa would play, would sing the tenor part, and it's just amazing. I enjoy those times. The family devotions we had. Sometimes I sleep through the lesson, but I would wake up because we would sing a closing hymn, and I enjoy that. If there's music and it's danceable, Papa would take the time, take Mama's hand, and they would dance. Papa would catch the moment. And lastly, Papa was always on my side. I was called to the principal's office, and before the meeting with the principal, Papa told me something. We're on the same side here. And I walked to that meeting. I wasn't kicked out. We were on the same side. So Papa, thank you for life. And I could say that through all this, it is well with my soul. Should I sing now?
When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well, it is well with my soul. It is well. Some peace tonight in the arms of an angel. Fly away from here, from the star-cold hotel and the endless stairs that you silence.
some comfort here. So tired of this straight line, and everywhere you turn, there's vultures and thieves at your back. The storm keeps on twisting, keep on feeding the lies that you make up for all that you lack. Makes no difference. Escape one last time. It's easier to believe in this sweetness. Oh, this glorious sadness that brings me to my knees in the arms of the angel. Fly away from here, from this dark, cold hotel room, and the endlessness that I fear. You are pulled from the wreckage of your silent memory. You're in the arms of the angel. May you
comfort. 就是三个了。Yeah.
You're in the arms of the angel. May you find some comfort here.
A lot has been said about Papa, about being soft-spoken, man of few words, officer and a gentleman, loving, kind. But don't get me wrong, just like Kuya Abet said, Pop's not perfect, just like all of us. But one thing I know is just like any other father, he just does things that he thinks is right and good for his family. Being a good father, you know, like, I could just say that for all the next generation in the clan, love your dad while they're here. I've met a lot of kids, those wayward kids, I would say, that really went the wrong track. And when you ask them why, they always say, because they didn't have a father figure. What shapes us right now, we can always say that a big part of it is from our father. If there's someone that would really be complaining about absentee father, it could be me. 6 years from childhood. No dad, no one reading books when you sleep, no one to play with. But I didn't take that wrong because I know decided to be without the family. Because that's what he thinks is best for us. And I just embraced it, really. So when he went back from his stint in the States, I was 6 years old, I was just trying to cope. It's me. It's me who's saying, come on, let's catch up. So I encourage you again. Guys, yeah,
Don't blame it in your father. They just do what they think is right at the moment. And the last one I would like to share is Papa, his love for Mama. That's the thing I try to emulate. I'm still not perfect, but the way he loves Mama is something that will be with me. He loves Mom so much. As I said, it's not perfect, but yeah, he agrees with me. Happy wife, happy life, you know. But yeah, he's a very loving dad, a very giving dad. If there's someone that would settle things, it's gonna be him first. So I encourage you, husbands, if you have an argument, take the first initiative. That is our responsibility, to love our wife. I'm not perfect as well. Archie would tell that. But that's our mandate. So I would like to share a song.
We found each other, someone up there, honey, in it long before we ever knew. Now we just cannot believe we have gone this far for 60 solid years together. We thank you, Lord, for giving us to each other. Looking back through the years, I found a beautiful and charming young lady whom I firmly believe to be my future wife. And on 27 November 1955, I married her. Lord, how great thou art indeed. We have entrusted to you our lives for the years to come, the journey we will have to travel in this world called life, the trials we have to face, living just one day at a time, trusting in your promises that you will never leave or forsake us. And today, we are celebrating and thanking the Lord for all the blessings he bestowed upon our family.
Have all been answered. I finally arrived. The healing that has been delayed is now realized. No one's in a hurry, there's no schedule to keep. We're all enjoying Jesus, just sitting at his feet. If you could see me now, I'm walking streets of gold. If you could see me now, I'm standing tall and whole. If you could see me now, you'd know I've seen his face. If you could see me now, you know the pain's erased. You wouldn't want me to ever leave this place. If only you could see me now. My light and temporary trials have worked out for my good. To know it brought in glory when I misunderstood. Though we had our sorrows, they can never compare to what Jesus has in store for us. No language can share. If you could see me now, I'm walking streets of gold. If you could see me now, I'm standing tall and whole. If you could see me now, you know I've seen his face. If you could see me now, you know the pain's erased. If we could see him now, he's walking streets of gold. If we could see him now, he's standing tall and whole. If we could see him now, we know he's seen his face. If we could see him now, we know the pain's erased. We wouldn't want him to ever leave the place. Only we could see him now. If we could see him now. And he tells us, if you could see me now.
Our best memories of Lola is him dancing around the living room or randomly making cow noises or animal noises. We're not entirely sure why, but it was probably just to make us laugh. And Dad, you're so right. His love for Lola was a true inspiration. And this was really difficult for me to find a song and to even sing a song. But I chose Old Rugged Cross because above all, Lola was a God-fearing man. On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross where the tears had best for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last are laid down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. Oh, that old rugged cross, so despised by the world, has a wondrous attraction for me. For the dear Lamb of God left his glory above to bear it on dark Calvary. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross
Lolo has taught us how to love. Like Dad was saying, he has such incredible love for Lola. And he's taught me how to love. He's taught us how to love. And so we would love to dedicate this song to him and Lola. Nathan, my fiance, would just like to share some words as well about Lolo.
Dear Lolo, you inspire me with the life you lived through the stories I have heard and the moments I have seen. I admire your strength and authority. All your qualities and legacy will live on through each of your kids, grandkids, and even great-grandkids. I will miss those precious moments where I heard you speak few but very powerful words. You were the one who taught me the word apo and have shown me what it means to be a Lolo. Until we meet again.
And Zach would also like to say something to Lolo.
Lola has been a very big influence to my life. I'll always cherish, I'll always keep his memories with me. And through the hard times, he'll always be in my heart. I love Lola. And Lola, I love you too. Keep safe.
Remember me, don't have to say goodbye. Remember. My darling, death took your body. God took your soul. My mind holds our memories of being together for 64 years, 4 months and 21 days. My heart keeps our love forever. My faith gives me the assurance that we will meet once again for a sweet reunion. I love you, darling, and I will love you forever.
This would be one of the requests of Papa, that during his celebration of life, when he goes home to be with the Lord, he said, "Son, you preach an evangelistic message, and the Lord impressed on my heart, if you have your Bibles with you, this would be short and sweet. Open your Bibles to Revelation chapter 14, verse 13. And the Bible, the Word of God, teaches that life does not end at the grave. Amen. The eternal spirit and image of God within us, within each and every one of us, cannot be destroyed by the death of the physical body. And in our text for today, the Apostle John wrote in Revelation chapter 14, verse 13, that says, "I heard a voice from heaven say, write, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord from now on. Yes, says the Spirit, they will rest from their labor, for their deeds will follow them." John was the author of this last book of the Bible, or the last book of the New Testament, the book of Revelation. And this particular book, especially this specific text, gives us a view of death from the other side. Because from the human vantage point, death appears to be dreadful. Death appears to be defeating, and death appears to be devastating. But from God's vantage point, God calls the dead blessed or blessed. And the word blessed, in Greek, it means makarios. And literally, the word means happy or fortunate or to be congratulated. Why is this so, my dear brethren and friends? Because from now on, even as I speak, those who die, who have placed their faith and trust in the Lord, will rest from their labors and their deeds will follow them. That's what the verse says in Revelation chapter 14, verse 13. One theologian described death this way, and I quote, "Death is the golden key that opens the palace of eternity." This specific theologian, This specific theologian showed death as the doorway into the marvelous life beyond. Because death is an entrance into eternal life, it becomes a blessed and fortunate experience for God's people. Now, for God's people, like our beloved Papa, to me and my siblings, and others that fondly call him by that name, this man, he's not perfect, as I said. This man was a darling and devoted husband to our mama. He was a loving and sweet Lolo to the grandchildren and great-grandchildren. He was a thoughtful and caring uncle to nephews and nieces. He was a true and a big manong and kuya, although my dad's stature was petite, so to speak, small. But he was. His heart was big. And he was a true manong and kuya to the others, and a very good friend and brother in Christ to the rest. Now, that then is the doorway to rest, that is the doorway to rewards, and that is the doorway to the resurrection. Three R's, and I will deal with each one of that in a short while. Those are the three main points. As we celebrate this life of Papa, that's why it's called, this service called the celebration of life. Let's go to the first one. Death is the doorway to rest. The Apostle John says that death is the doorway to rest from our labors, according to the very verse itself. And the word labor describes a wearing out from work or from a wearisome toil. It suggests to us that life is often hard, isn't it? It can be full of difficulties and disappointments and diseases, like what we are experiencing now. And with this situation and condition, it's easy for us to grow weary of the struggle, and then we long for rest and relief. That is the doorway into that rest for God's people. And there comes a time when we need to lay down our burdens and to be at rest. Now, the key word rest here in our text is a beautiful word. It means to be at ease and to be refreshed. It means an end to the toils and tribulations of life. In Matthew 28, the Word of God, the Bible says, verses 11 to 30, it says there, "Come to me, all you," most of us know this by heart, "Come to me, all you who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you," what? Rest. The Lord Jesus, furthermore, he said, "Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light." In this world of trouble, especially for such a time as this, global COVID-19, the pandemic, we can know rest, right? But there's a greater and more complete rest for us when we go home to be with the Lord. It is the rest of heaven and the very presence of God. And those who went home to be with the Lord, such as my beloved Papa, who have laid their burdens down and entered into that rest, they are blessed and truly fortunate. That is not only the doorway to rest, but also that is the doorway to reward. John states in this particular verse that their deeds will follow them. It's very clear. Let me tell us that we are all making a record here on earth, all of us for that matter, and we will carry the record of our life with us into eternity. How, Pastor Albert, you might ask? Let me tell you, by the lives that we live, by the words that we say, by the deeds that we do, we are laying up for ourselves treasures in heaven. The Bible tells us in Hebrews chapter 6, verse 10, that God will not forget our works and labor of love, which we have done in Jesus' name as we minister to others. All of these things are part of our permanent record that we shall carry with us into eternity. You know, my dear family, brethren, and friends, all of us would be leaving something in this life here on earth, like the legacy and the influence that my father left and impressed to all of us. Most of us gave, the entire family, even the grandkids gave their tribute to their lolo. We gave our tribute to our papa. He left an imprint in our lives. How he has blessed and touch our lives. That's why what I'm saying is that our influence or our testimony, whether good or bad, remains long after we are gone from this earth. Do you know that our works will follow us and will accompany us to the very judgment of God? Well, okay, please don't misunderstand the judgment of God. What I meant to say here is that the purpose of the judgment is not to determine our destiny, but to determine our reward from God. We determine that here and now while we are still alive by being assured of our personal relationship with our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The Bible makes it clear. It's only as we put our faith and trust in Jesus that we will have eternal life and dwell with God in heaven forever and ever. The Lord Jesus, his very words in John chapter 14, verse 6, this is what he said, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." That's what Jesus said. My beloved father, Papa Alex, he chose to follow the Lord Jesus Christ throughout his life, during his life here on earth. And because of that decision and commitment, I am very sure, my dear family and friends, I am very sure that Papa Alex now is in the very presence of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ forever and ever. And there will be one day There will be one day, one blessed day, that I will see my Papa Alex once again. Also because of my personal relationship with Jesus Christ. And to those that prayed to receive Jesus sincerely into their lives, we will see him again. We will all be reunited in heaven. Remember, the Bible says that we are saved by God's grace alone and by faith in Jesus Christ alone. But we will be rewarded by our works. If and when we have lived faithfully and served God joyfully and lovingly, like my Papa Alex, there's where death becomes the doorway to our reward. And those who have gone to a good reward like Papa are indeed blessed or blessed. They are fortunate and they are to be congratulated. And finally, death is not only the doorway to rest and reward, but also that death is the doorway to the resurrection. Well, Pastor Albert, the resurrection is not mentioned in Revelation 14, verse 13. Well, it's not mentioned there, but it is affirmed and confirmed in the Word of God in 1 Corinthians 15, verses 20 to 22. That's the train behind our church. Yeah, could always hear that. It says there, Christ has indeed been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since death came through a man, the resurrection of the dead comes also through a man. For as in Adam, all die, so in Christ, all will be made alive. Meaning to say that the Bible teaches more than the immortality or the survival of the spirit of man. It also teaches the resurrection of the body, this body that we have, the physical body. Meaning that those who die in Christ will go immediately to be with the Lord Jesus Christ in heaven. If you are a Christian, when you go home to be with the Lord, you will immediately go into heaven. There's no roaming around the earth. It will be a new and glorious resurrection body. It will be like the resurrected body of the Lord Jesus Christ. That body of ours would be changed. It will live forever. Jesus declared this in John 11, 25, that states, I am, these are the very words of Jesus, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live, even though he dies. And he who lives and believes in me will never die. Amen. And again, the Lord Jesus Christ declared in John 14, verse 19, he said this to his disciples and to us, the present day disciples. He said, before long, the world will not see me anymore, but you will see me because I live, you also will live. But I would like us to be reminded that this resurrection life does not belong to all people. It's only a promise to people like Papa Alex who die in the Lord, because he has a personal relationship with our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. That is meant by the phrase, those who die in the Lord, from that very verse. It's only as you and I commit ourselves to Jesus Christ and follow him as Savior and Lord of the totality of our lives. If we do that, if and when we do that, that can be a blessed experience for us, like it did to my Papa. When you have Jesus Christ as your Savior and Lord, that becomes a blessed experience for you. It becomes the doorway to rest, to reward, and the resurrection. It becomes the entrance into eternal life, salvation in Christ alone, heaven itself. Let me close with this. An unknown poet expressed this truth so beautifully when he wrote, and I quote, "The stars shine on the earth, and the stars shine on the sea. The stars shine on the face of God, and the stars shine down on me. The stars shall shine for 1,000 years, for 1,000 years and a day. But my Lord Jesus Christ and I shall still live when the stars have faded away. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. At this time, I would like us, for us all, thank you for coming. Heads bowed, eyes closed. Let's just respond to the message that we just heard today, this evening or this morning in your time or this afternoon. Heads bowed, eyes closed. Let's make this a time of prayer. I would like you to be totally honest with God right now as we come into this prayer time. Be open. Open your heart to God. I would like you to be sincere and transparent with God, individually, silently. Perhaps some of you are saying, Pastor Albert, I would like that rest, that kind of rest, that kind of peace that Papa Alex had. Help me and pray for me. The Bible makes it clear, my dear friends, that all you need to do is to admit that you are hopeless and helpless, that you are a sinner and you cannot save yourself. Admit that before God. Be honest with Him. Next is to believe. We just had celebrated Holy Week. You know the significance of the Holy Week? God's love, unconditional love to us. And so you believe that Jesus Christ died for your sins, for all of your sins and my sins, for the sins of the whole world. He is the only and the ultimate sacrifice. And next is you should confess your sins, repent of your sins, and commit your life to Him. Silently and individually right now, I would like you to open your heart to God and just follow this simple prayer of faith with me. Just follow while I lead us silently, individually between you and God. Follow this prayer of faith. Lord Jesus, thank you for dying on the cross for all of my sins. Lord Jesus, I admit that I am a sinner and I cannot save myself. Lord Jesus, I am hopeless and helpless without you. Today, I confess and repent of all of my sins. Help me, forgive me, and cleanse me from all unrighteousness. Today, I commit my life to you and receive you as my personal Savior and Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. You can open the eyes now. You know what? If you have prayed that simple prayer of faith, the Word of God, the Bible, is very clear. It says there in John chapter 6, verse 47, truly, truly, I say to you, he who believes or has faith in Jesus has everlasting life or eternal life. Let's close in prayer. Let's pray. Our dear God and Father in heaven, through Jesus Christ, our Lord, and through the intercession of the Holy Spirit, we praise you and thank you, Lord, for decisions that have been made tonight. Perhaps there might be in our online meeting that have prayed this simple prayer of faith. Continue to work in and through their lives, dear God. I pray that you would keep them strong and steadfast in their faith and trust in you. Dear God, our Father, we thank you because you are the one who breaks our bondage from sin, death, and hell, because you have conquered and you have been victorious over sin, death, and hell. You, O Lord, are the one who provides us our eternal home, because you said there, in your Father's house are many mansions. You said that in John chapter 14. You are the one who gives us the peace that is everlasting, the peace that is beyond death, the peace that this world can neither give nor take away, the peace that passes all understanding, the peace that will guard our hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. You, O Lord, are the one who turns our sorrow into celebration. You turn our sadness into joy. You turn our loss into confidence, O Lord. And we thank you, and we praise you, and we give you all the glory, the honor, and the praise. In Jesus' most precious and priceless name, we pray. Amen. And amen. And amen.
Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of fear. Thou changest not thy compassions in
Father God, we give you thanks and we praise your name for giving us the victory, the life that is abundant and eternal through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and through the fellowship and the guidance of the Holy Spirit. Bless each and every one of us all. The Lord bless us and keep us. The Lord make his face to shine upon us and be gracious unto us. The Lord lift up his countenance on us and grant us peace from this time forth and forevermore. And all God's people say, amen, amen and amen.